buzzer in from crashing yesterday.
Oh, magnifique, je l'ai dans la vidéo.
And yeah, 4.5 hours sleep, and somebody kept banging something all night. Who was that fucking banging?
Who's that truck, man?
I felt like getting out of bed and saying, "Hey, fuck off." Yeah. Anyway, just kept waking up because of that.
I didn't even get a shower because
I wanted to go to bed. I keep thinking that I've not done something on the bike. I hope it's alright. Another day. Another beasting.
Fuck.
The attrition on this rally is massive. This is tough, man. Tough. Alright, we've got to get up and get this thing going.
Message from my girlfriend.
Good morning, my love. Happy Wednesday. I hope you have a great mood to start the day and get some good healthy food, some Yorkshire black tea with milk, and have a great journey today, okay? Just take it easy, enjoy it, and have a great day. Talk to you later. Bye bye, my love.
Ah, nice little message this morning. Just take it easy, drink some Yorkshire tea, and have some nice breakfast. Thank you, love. I can't wait, she's coming, and she said if I get to the finish, she's coming down. So,
you back at the finish then?
The day before, she said she'll be here.
Stage 11, just sat on the start line. Really need to, no crashing today, I need to try and keep it smooth. I think it's important for me just to keep a nice steady pace, no mistakes, and get to the end of the rally safely now. Managed to get 4.5 hours sleep, so not the best, the shortest night yet, but a lot better than last year. Yeah, another day, another stage.
Come on, Lyndon, you can fucking ride a bike. Jesus Christ.
come on.
Summary of stage 11, brutal again. Just today was my worst day of the rally. I really struggled to get into a rhythm. Whatever I did, I just couldn't seem to get moving properly, you know, in a flow. So I was just hitting everything wrong, and yeah, just didn't go well at all, really. I dropped the bike 3 times in the first 10 kilometers. And after that, I started to feel tired, and I just said, you know, it's probably because I was late in last night, working on the bike till midnight. So I just decided, you know what, just take it easy and get to the end, because I can't win this thing today, but I can definitely lose it. And so that's what I did. I took it really steady, actually, like, got passed by about 30 bikes in the stage. But it just didn't feel right today, so better to do that than to end up in a place that I don't want to be. So a brutal, rough stage though, so rough, it was really hard to get the rhythm going, and just the terrain didn't suit me, just wasn't suited to my riding style, so hopefully we'll get something a little bit nicer tomorrow. But other than that, happy to be here. But
I'm feeling it for sure. I need to get a good night's sleep, so I'm going to crack on with everything and see if I can get to bed early. Quick update from the end of Fiambala 1 and marathon stage Dakar 2018, stage 11. I'm in the marathon bivouac, just been doing a little bit of work on the bike, but just wanted to let you all know that the stage tomorrow has been cancelled. At first, the 120 kilometres was cut out at the beginning of the stage at altitude here because of the cloudy weather conditions forecast in the morning, which means the helicopters can't fly, so for the competitor safety they cut that out. But what that meant is that the cars and trucks that are now in San Juan would be running on the stage first, and there's a lot of riverbeds and sandy areas with rocks, and the trucks and cars uproot all the rocks, and in all the soft sand it makes it really dangerous. Rightly so, they've reconsidered and they've now decided to cancel the stage on safety grounds. I don't know whether that's just for the bikes. I think it'll be just for the bikes, so we're just riding to San Juan. I'm going to bed. Good night, folks. I'll be back tomorrow.